All right, welcome back. We are back with our model of society. Remember, society is a machine. It takes human beings and turns them into patterned thoughts and behaviors. Where we left off last time was we were dealing with this side, which you can tell I've resized things to make room for what we need to talk about, but this side, the symbolic universe, all the things that hold meaning, and the collective consciousness, the beliefs a society has, we talked about the fact that those two things together add up to culture, which was right here and isn't anymore because we're moving on to the other side of the story. Culture is responsible for our thoughts, but we also are turned into behaviors. The part of the machine that turns us into behaviors is called the social structure. Social structure is, for me, much more concrete, easy to talk about than culture. Social structure is going to be defined for us as a system of statuses and norms. Social structure, system of statuses and norms. Statuses are going to be defined very simply as positions in a society. In a society. So statuses are positions. Norms are going to be the expected behaviors that are attached to those statuses. So social structure, a system of statuses or positions, and norms, expected behaviors. Simple as that. The whole thing can be sort of visualized as a big flowchart, in which I've drawn for you. This is as mediocre as my other drawing as well. This is a very mediocre flowchart for a university. So it's got a president. A president is a status, it's a position. When you get done with one president of a university, you move on to a different one. A different person inhabits that. Underneath the president are vice presidents. And there are relationships, specific ways that this status is supposed to act toward that status. And those lines that connect the statuses can be thought of as the norms. Underneath the vice presidents, you've got deans. Underneath deans, you've got department heads. Underneath department heads, you've got professors, administrative assistants, work-study students. And all of them are connected. All of those positions are connected by particular norms of behavior, particular expected behaviors. And I should have drawn you guys in here too, but you guys would be down here underneath professors, and there's a specific way, we're going to move back over, a specific way that I am supposed to interact with you. There are all kinds of ways that I could interact with students that would be inappropriate, right? I could walk into a classroom and start hugging or singing to my students. That's obviously inappropriate, although, really importantly, I'm a human being and I'm capable of doing those things, and in some situations, those behaviors are appropriate, just not when I am in the status of professor. I'm sorry, I'm going to tilt you back over toward this for just one more moment to make this point. So this is just a set of statuses and norms for one very small part of society. I, right now, am in this box. I'm in the status of professor, but I wasn't before I came to shoot this video. Before that, I was in a different box. I was in the box of driver, a different status that requires different behaviors of me than the one I'm in right now. Before that, I was at home, and I was in the status of parent. I was working with my daughter on her math, and that was part of what you do as a parent. After this, I will leave here, and I've got to go pick up some food for my family, so I will be in the status of driver again for a brief period of time, and then I will be in the status of shopper at the grocery store. And what you can see, I'll move you away from this now, what you can see is when I am inserted into this machine, there are a whole bunch of different boxes that I will step into at one time or another. If you think about the social structures, if you think about that big system I drew, think about every possible position that could exist within a society. You would have a flowchart the size of, gosh, I don't know, the size of a skyscraper, really. I mean, it would be huge because there are probably thousands of different positions that you could fall into. Now, importantly, you and I right now are in different statuses, right? I'm in the status, the position of teacher. You're in the status, the position of student. But if we both stop this video and we both go off driving, we are in the same status. We have the same, we're in the same position. We're both drivers, and there's we will both obey the same expected behaviors. All of the statuses that I inhabit throughout my life are what's called my status set. So status set is attached to a particular individual. So I've got the status set of husband, father, brother, son, coach, professor, driver, all of those things. And there are also some, those are all, most of those are achieved statuses. Achieved statuses are things that I had to go through an initiation rite to get into. So I had to get a master's degree to be able to teach you. That was my initiation rite, the norms I had to go through to get into the status. But there are also statuses, and you remember this probably from intro, ascribed statuses. My white skin, my maleness are things that I didn't have to go through an initiation rite for. I just got those. But those are positions that are important. I am interacted with on the basis of right now being a college professor, but when I walk across campus, I will be interacted with on the basis of my maleness, my whiteness, my middle-agedness. I'm not going to, in the way that a woman might be interacted with, I'm not going to have some guy walk up to me, look me up and down, and then keep walking, or even hit on me. Even if it was a gay guy walking toward me, I'm not going to be put through that same sort of process that American society has decided is acceptable for women. So my achieved statuses are usually what I'm interacted with, but ascribed statuses make a difference in terms of our day-to-day life as well. All right. So, quick recap, we're about halfway through this video. Social structure, a system of statuses and norms that exists for the entire society. Again, think of every possible status and the norms of behavior that connect them. Statuses are positions in society. Norms are expected behaviors, and they're attached to statuses. Okay, I have a status set that's attached to me, all the statuses that I have, but my experience and your experience of the social structure is situations. Right now, if we were in a classroom, it's a little bit clearer to see it that way. We would be in a situation called sociology class. And in that situation, there are statuses and norms. And we would interact on the basis of those statuses and norms. If we were walking across campus and we didn't know each other, or even if we did, our interaction would be a little bit different. I wouldn't stop you and start lecturing to you, even though that's an appropriate behavior for me when I'm in the status of college professor, because when I'm walking across campus, I'm just guy walking across campus. I'd probably look at you, wave, smile, but then keep walking. My behavior, and this is crucial for social structure, my behavior is not determined by me as an individual. It's determined by where I happen to be in the social structure, what situation I'm in. The situation determines the behavior. I will act in a sociology class in the exact same way all the time, and I will never act that way when I'm in the grocery store, because the situation is different. Where I am in the social structure is different. Pause if you need to, but consider that's the crucial part of this whole social structure lecture. I get inserted into society. Culture is determining what I'm thinking, but my behavior is determined by what status I happen to be in any particular situation. Social structure, it's divided up here. Ignore that for just a moment. I step through into the machine. My behaviors are determined by where I am in the social structure. Let me scroll my script down for just a moment. Oh, okay. So now we will pay attention to these two parts of the social structure. The interaction order and social institutions. I've written social institutions much bigger because that's where we're going to be spending our time during this class. These correspond to different types of different types of situations. Informal situations fall under the category of the interaction order. This is you hanging out with your friends, you walking across campus. Those are not formal situations, they're informal. Formal situations would directly contribute to us meeting our needs as a society. But when you're hanging out with your friends, playing video games or doing whatever, you're at a party, those are informal. They're not crucial to us meeting our needs. That is the interaction order. Importantly, it's patterned as well. I mean, you can think about the way you walk across campus. You walk up, you see somebody, you drop your eyes, you walk, you get closer, you look up, you smile, make eye contact, maybe say what's up, and then you keep walking. The whole thing's patterned though, right? Even those informal interactions. And your friends expect consistent behavior from you. If you are the loud person, they expect that. And if you're quiet, it's like, what's wrong? So again, this is patterned, even though it's informal. But where we're going to spend our time the rest of the semester is here in social institutions. These are the formal situations that we are in. A situation, formal situations are situations in which we are directly meeting one of the needs of society. Let me just make sure. I think I might be done with everything I wanted to talk about. Yeah, that's everything I want to talk about. All of this social structure stuff is a lead up to us dealing with one particular part of the social structure, formal situations, what we're going to name social institutions, because that's where organizations live. So next video, which will be our last one for Unit 1, we will actually get to what social institutions are about and how organizations fit within that. So I'll see you in that video.